What I'll do, I'm gonna play you a piece of silence, okay? I know you feel that. Don't lie. What makes Marciac special is the public, and they have a beautiful energy, just looking forward to sharing, you know, the energy and the spirit with everybody.
Hello, it's Domino. How are you? Fine?
All right.
Check one, two.
Bonjour à tous, nous recevons aujourd'hui Marcus Miller à Jazz in Marciac avant son show ce soir. Hello, Mr. Miller. Nice to meet you, it's a pleasure. Could you tell us, when did you fall in love with jazz?
I think I fell in love with jazz when I was about 14 years old. I was playing R&B, soul music, funk music, for a couple of years. And then I heard Herbie Hancock and the Headhunters. Mm-hmm. And it was a beautiful mix of soul music and funk music and jazz. And then I started following Herbie Hancock. And
every time I read interview about you, there are always questions about Miles Davis. Are you a bit tired about that?
No, I mean, it's like somebody asking you about your parents. You know, you don't get tired to talk about your parents, yeah. You know? What I've done with Miles is not the only accomplishment in my life. And so I don't have any problem talking about it.
What do you keep inside your music from Miles?
The thing that's most important that I got from Miles is you have to be yourself. You have to figure out who you are and then put that in your music. I love traditional jazz, and if you listen carefully, you will hear the influence of traditional jazz. But my music has funk, it has music from the Caribbean, music from Africa, you know, music from New York. Mm-hmm. Everything that I grew up with, you hear in my music.
Your history is important in your job.
When I play music, man, you're going to hear in my music Slam Stewart, you're gonna hear Paul Chambers, you're gonna hear Ron Carter, you're gonna hear Larry Graham, Stanley Clarke, Chaco Pastorius, all the way through, and a lot of other people that I didn't name because the history comes through you. A lot of bass players play like this,
yeah.
And you can get nice rhythm like this.
Mm-hmm.
But with this thing, it's almost like having another drummer. The slap was invented by a guy named Larry Graham. And Larry Graham was the bass player for Sly and the Family Stone. Okay. And they had a hit called Dance to the Music. And Larry Graham was the guy who played like that.
What is your feeling with the new generation?
I'm very excited about the new generation. I'm excited because, you know, I think we had an era of conservatism where people after the 70s jazz was so crazy. There were so many different types of jazz, so many different versions, and free jazz and Latin jazz. Yeah, and people were uncomfortable. And I think in the 80s, everybody just said, okay, let's hit the reset button, you know? And I think that's been done, and I think that's ending now. And I see young musicians who are ready to move forward. I got appointed an Artist for Peace by UNESCO. I've realized for a long time, man, that music is such a beautiful way to communicate with people. You know, if I play something for you and you like it, I don't have to say anything. And if I play something that has an emotion and you feel the same emotion, then we realize that we are similar. And that's very important. So the first step to peace is communication. So I'm really looking forward to doing some work.